But I'm very high on happiness right now.
I'm glad to hear that. Yes. I'm just trying to find my position. Does anyone have a cushion? Okay. Let's just deal with it.
Yeah.
Right?
That's low. Okay.
Okay. So, Ananya, starting off with, I want to congratulate you on your positive initiative.
Thank you.
I think it's amazing when, you know, honestly, I think so many of us are in a sea of negativity without even realizing it. What was the turning point for you?
There were quite a few, actually. So I think initially when I was in school, I wouldn't say I was bullied, but I feel like when you're that age, when you're so young, people don't realize that their words hurt and that it can impact you for the rest of your life. Like, I feel like a lot of stuff that people said to me when I was younger, it subconsciously still sticks with me, and it's some of my biggest insecurities. And so there was a lot of stuff in school, and after that, I think because my dad is an actor, I think I was exposed to the public and to the media at a very young age. So I feel like a lot of my pictures went online at a very young age. So a lot of negativity would come from there. And then not just with me, but with a lot of my friends who are also in the public eye, I saw a lot of negativity towards them. And I kept thinking, why isn't anyone saying anything about it, or why isn't anyone doing anything about it? And then an incident happened with me where someone claimed that I lied about my education, and that I didn't get into college. And it really frustrated me because I wasn't lying, and I was like, it's so scary how people can just believe what they read on the internet, how easily, you know, wrong information can spread.
There's no fact checking,
no one's validating the facts, and no one is, you know, proving them right or wrong. But then I don't even blame the people who are reading it, because that's news, right? That's where they're getting all
the
information from.
That's the way we're consuming news, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, we were discussing earlier how hard it is for us to wake up and not
check
our phones.
Yeah.
How many of you do that? How many of you give yourselves 15 minutes before you look at your phone? No,
do,
he doesn't.
No, who do you give time before looking?
Who gives your phone?
We need to learn from her.
You do?
My hand is just constantly scrolling, like, involuntarily. I'm just like,
I almost find like I'm having an affair with my phone.
Yeah.
Because my husband's very strict about not looking at your phone in the morning. It's bad for your eyes.
Yeah.
With the kids.
Yeah.
And I'm literally sneaking a look at my phone. We are ill.
Yeah, it's not okay.
Right? Don't you guys feel that way?
And I think it's such a scary thought that we derive so much of our self-confidence and
our validation
from Instagram. And just imagine one day if Instagram just gets deleted, like all of your friends who you think you have on social media and all these likes and comments, they'll just disappear. Then what do we have left? I think we've stopped valuing human relationships and contact with someone, just talking to someone
exactly.
in person.
And I think that's because what's happened now is, you know, with social media, it's so easy for so many anonymous people to have a view on your life.
Exactly.
They either like your dress, or they like your makeup,
yeah.
or they disagree with your philosophy or what you're thinking
of.
But those same people, you start believing that they are they are your friends. And that's the dangerous part, because when you need someone, when something actually happens to you, where you're emotionally uncomfortable, where are those friends? They aren't there.
Yeah.
So I feel we have to go back to human contact.
Yeah.
I mean, like today, on my way from Ananya's van to here, I hugged 6 people, and that was the highlight of my day.
Yeah.
And I feel we have to touch each other more, we have to feel each other more, right?
Yeah, for sure.
And people have stopped doing that.
Yeah.
Like, a heart doesn't replace real love.
Exactly. And it's so scary because you don't even know if those people are real or just like robots. Like, so many people are like catfishing people out there.
No, and also what their actual mental state is.
Yeah. And I feel like there's just a lot of negativity in general on social media, because it's such an easy way to reach to people. You know what you're going to say is directly going to be read by someone, and you're going to affect them immediately. Like, it's such an immediate response that you get.
I think it also affects our emotional quotient, right?
Sure.
Like, you know, you put something up, and then for the next 10 minutes, you're a bit emotional. Will people like it? Will they diss it? Will they judge you?
And then if you don't get enough likes, you go and delete the picture.
I don't post it.
So many people do that. If you say you don't do that, then you're lying.
I swear I don't. I only delete something if I feel it might be controversial. But in fact, I've become such a scary cat that I just put up happy things. And like I was saying to you, you know, I really feel that, you know, there's a oneness. Like, we're all wanting to be more positive.
Yeah.
I mean, the comments I've been getting, the love I've been getting, and I've been seeing other people, including yourself, getting that. So it's, I think we're on the cusp of something special. Yeah. Yeah. And I think all of us together, if we can pledge
yeah.
to like give people more time,
yeah.
Spread positivity yeah, yeah. On social media, yeah. don't you think that would like...
No, I think it's the easiest thing to do. Just like leave one nice comment on someone's picture. Like, don't you all get excited when you go to the bathroom and when you're out at night and you're partying and you go to the bathroom and that one girl comes to you in the bathroom and she's like, I love your shoes. Like, doesn't that make you so happy? So just do that. Just say one nice thing to someone. I promise it'll make your day so much better and it'll make their day so much better. So just even one nice thing can actually change someone's day, mood, absolutely. Life. It just... No one is valuing positivity and kindness, you know, it's very underrated. Just say one nice thing, I promise, you'll feel so much lighter.
So do you, I mean, you know, you're an actor and you're out there, you're, you know, dressed up every day. You're being judged for everything you do, whether it's your beauty look, whether it's you hanging out today at Lakme Fashion Week, you're going to be judged.
Yeah.
How do you deal with that?
I think, okay, so I'm not going to be like, oh, I'm this perfect person who doesn't get affected or doesn't get bogged down. Like, I've had days where I read like one sad comment and then I just lock my room and I start crying and I'm like, I want to delete Instagram and I don't want to do this anymore. But then I think I just, you know, keep my phone away for an hour and I just sit with my family and I sit with my friends and I sit with people who actually care, who actually are looking out for me, and I swear that makes everything better. Like, you know, just talking to someone, just letting your feelings out, just having a normal conversation with someone can just make you feel so much better. Just put it away for like an hour and I promise you'll feel so much better. But I also feel like it's okay to feel what you're feeling. You know, don't put so much pressure on trying to be happy all the time. You know, if you're feeling something, just feel it. Just feel it, just go through it. If you're sad, if you're angry, just let it out and it'll just, you'll just grow from there. You know, you'll learn from every experience that you go through, because I feel like people are too hard on themselves. They put too, because they see someone's life on Instagram and that person's happy and that person's traveling and that person, someone's in a relationship, and you're like, why is my life not like that? And I want that. But I promise everyone has a battle that they're fighting. You know, no one posts their failures on Instagram. Everyone just posts the good parts of their life. So don't base reality on what you see on Instagram. You know, it's okay to be sad, it's okay to be a mess. I promise I'm a mess most of the time, but just go through it and you'll grow through it, I promise.
And again, it comes back to the same thing we were saying earlier, right? We were saying there's all these anonymous people passing comments. So why suddenly is it important to you? It's the same people who are faceless, nameless. We don't even know if that image is them.
Yeah.
And they're free to judge you positively and negatively. Yeah. So when you get happy with the positivity, I think that same part of your brain needs to be activated to say the negativity is nothing. Let it go.
And I feel like these people, they're not going to ever come up to you in person and actually say those things. You know, I feel like the trolls and all those negative people, they're probably going through something in their lives as well. They've probably never felt that love. They have that void somewhere. And I feel like if you give love back to them, you'll probably be filling that void and you'll probably make a troll a nicer, more positive person. So I never feel like you should give hate back to hate. You should always reply with love and it fixes a lot of things. Yeah.
So who's your digital escape? Like, who do you stalk on Instagram?
Everyone. I stalk everyone on Instagram. Everyone stalks everyone on Instagram.
What's your guilty pleasure?
What's my guilty pleasure? Seeing people's stories. I love it. And then I don't see the last one. You know, I'm like, oh, I lost interest in the middle. That's like my
thing. Like, that's one too many vacay pictures.
So
do you feel like let's talk about the positive side of social media.
Okay.
You know, I mean, we know that cyberbullying is a horrible thing, and basically cyberbullying, what we refer to as cyberbullying, is any kind of bullying, any kind of negativity, any kind of critique that is not required on a digital medium. But like she said, no one really comes to you personally and says those same things. Now, of course, I've completely lost track of my mind and what I was going to ask you next. But what was it? I'll ask you. So, like, do you feel like you need to put in an extra effort because you are in the public eye?
No, for sure. I think I used to feel that way. I think I used to feel like I need to look a certain way, act a certain way, present myself a certain way. But I think I'm very fortunate to be surrounded by people who are letting me be myself. And I think that's the best advice anyone could have given me, is just be myself. And I think someone who I really look up to for that is Karan Johar, because he's so unabashedly himself. He's so comfortable. comfortable in his skin. And I think that's so motivating, you know, to see someone who's so happy and so free. And I want to be like that. And I think I'm trying a little bit every day to just be
as myself.
I think
he's an amazing role model. Yeah. Whether it's his fashion, whether it's his passion,
he wears it. But I think just be yourself. It's really not the, like, it's the easiest thing in the world to do is just be yourself. You know, the more you love yourself, I feel like the more people around you will love you. But that doesn't matter because you don't need validation from people around you. I think all that matters is you loving you. Self-love is the way to go.
Absolutely. Yeah. In a productive way.
Yeah. Yeah.
But tell me, if you could steal someone's Instagram life, who would it be?
Ooh.
And I say Instagram life. Social.
Right now, I'd like to steal Deepika's because she's on a holiday with
exactly.
Ranveer.
Only
who wouldn't want that?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
And do you guys have any suggestions of how we could all be more positive? Anyone?
Ori?
Yes, no. Ori.
That's
true, you are. So give us some words of advice.
Smile!
It's
exactly.
on our list.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we actually made a list of you know, things, how we feel everybody can be more positive. But I was hoping you guys would be a little more interactive. But smile. Let's start with smile. Can you stand up and smile to the audience, please? Yay. Everybody smile back.
Everyone smile.
Okay? It's something I learned, and as you go older, you're like very young, you will realize that you do not remember most people. But a warm smile is the best thing you can do to anyone. Even someone you don't know, you know, you don't know what someone's going through. So it's just the warmest way to greet someone.
I think strangers smiling, the strangers who pass
absolutely.
By and smile are like
absolutely.
The best kind of people.
And I think the energy here is very positive.
Yeah,
everyone's
smiling. Smiling. You're like very quiet, but you're smiling. I like that.
Too quiet. Come on, more suggestions.
A thank you note. Yes. Yes. You should always be grateful for everything that's happening in your life. And I actually believe when you wake up in the morning, you should say one thing that you're grateful for. That's it could be anything. It could be eating something for breakfast or meeting someone in that day. And then you should go to sleep with saying one thing good that happened in your day. And I feel like if nothing good has happened in your day, at least try to make something good happen in someone else's life. And that can be your good moment
exactly.
as well.
Do something
good
for
someone.
You know,
yeah.
you don't have to be known for it. Nobody
yeah.
needs to know. It can be an anonymous act of
kindness.
A random act of kindness.
Yeah.
So I think if we all become warriors of positivity
yeah.
and spread that message, we can spread it much more.
Yeah.
Any other suggestions? Come on.
Come on. Don't be
Nahid.
Shy.
Be kind.
Be
absolutely.
Complimentary.
Yeah. Say something good about
good,
someone,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Like, I mean, what people are saying, you don't always have to be like a smartass and say something rude or cheeky.
Yeah.
You can be nice.
And I honestly feel like if you want to help someone, there's a way to give constructive criticism. Like, I'm not saying that, oh, don't, you know, if you want to help someone, there's really a way that you can be constructive about it. You don't need to be a bully about it and you don't need to be rude about it. I feel like the way you say something is so important.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Change the way you
speak. Change
you know,
the way,
like, you know,
yeah.
say things more positively. Like,
yeah.
say, rather saying, oh, I don't like what you do, tell someone what you
like
about them, right? And I think, you know, we are actually the fashion industry, and I have to say this, we are the most inclusive and diverse industry
yeah.
that we know. And we're very privileged to be a part of it. And I feel we should use that good energy. I mean, Lakme Fashion Week has done this repeatedly, you know, it has always pushed the boundaries. And I feel we all need to be ambassadors of change, right?
Yeah.
Because if we don't make that change, it's not going to happen. And now's the time.
So I have a question for
yes.
you.
Oh dear.
So whenever some troll or something says, oh, I don't like what you made this person wear, do you actually reflect on what you did and change that?
So first, my initial reaction is anger. And then I feel I should say something back because they're not understood. Then I reflect on it and I don't respond because I don't want to start a conversation.
Yeah.
But I think I do that because I feel they didn't get the point. I never think they're right. So I always feel I knew what I was doing and I knew the reason why I was doing it. So yeah, it doesn't really bother me.
Okay.
What bothers me is when people make personal comments on someone I've styled and I find it so distasteful, you know, like on someone's size or their expression, and I just feel like, you know, let's all hold a mirror to ourselves.
Yeah.
Not perfect.
Yeah.
None of us are.
And you shouldn't be, please don't be perfect. Being
perfect,
is
boring.
Yeah. It's really boring.
Yeah.
You know, just be yourself, just do some musti and just live.
And you know, the other thing I have to say, which we so underestimate, because you know, we've become such city rats, right? Like we're either at a mall or we're like, you know, in an air-conditioned restaurant. We're never outdoors. Don't you feel there's something amazing about being under the sky?
So I would really urge people to spend more time outdoors, like go out there, you know, like on your weekend, make that effort. Don't just binge watch. I mean, you know, do that one day and the next day. Like, we were just making serious plans for our next shoot schedule to go diving with the whales and like skydiving.
There's so much to do in this world. We're so stuck in our phones and in this virtual world, but there's so much out there. There's so many people to meet, so many conversations to have, so many cakes to eat. So just go do it, you know, just like step out of your phone and just live your life.
And then we were talking about music. So what music helps you get into the mood?
I don't think anyone wants to know. It's all Hindi, Bollywood jams like Aankh Mare or hookup songs.
Your own songs also.
Songs. Yeah. But whatever music makes you fly, I think music is the best therapy.
Absolutely.
It can just bring a smile on anyone's face. So music helps, food helps, spending time with my loved ones helps, spending time with my dogs helps.
A good blow dry?
A good blow dry helps.
Isn't that like a
good
lift for women, ladies? Don't you feel that?
Nice.
The minute you do your hair, just feel
and nails. There's something about doing your hair and nails. I don't know what it is.
Yeah. Okay. And what else? You know, sharing. I think we've all been taught, like, if you have a problem, deal with it. If you have a problem, I mean, I hate saying this, but man up.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
What is that?
Yeah.
We are all human and we all have emotions. And I think that's when our friends come in, right? When we say, like, you know, friends are the family you choose. And I believe that so strongly.
Yeah.
You know, you should
definitely let
it
out.
Share.
Yeah.
Right? Share your issues.
Yeah. You should talk to people, because I feel like the more you keep in, the more negative you become. I think a good way to release your stress and is just to talk it out. And you know, I think when you're young, you feel like your parents don't understand and you feel like they're not there for you and they're from another generation. But I promise they understand. Just try to explain
definitely
it to them.
Not your parents.
No, they're not my parents. But
they're young.
I know all parents are the same. You know, they love you and they're the only people who are going to actually look out for you unconditionally. And you might fight with them and you might feel like they're not on your side, but they're the only people on your side. Trust me, when you're down and no one is on your side, only your parents are there for you. So just talk to them, talk to a teacher, talk to a friend, and just let it out. Whoever it has to be, just no one on your phone, but in person, just let it out.
Yeah. So, I mean, tell me, how do you deal with, like, you know, because you're so in the public eye when relationships happen and the relationships break. How do you deal with that? How do you deal with that? I think it's very important for people to know that everything that's on social media is permanent. How do you deal with that pressure?
I don't really take pressure. I think I realize that I'm young and I'll make mistakes in my life. And it's okay as long as I own up to those mistakes. Like, I'm not a very private person. I'm a khuli kitab. Like, I'll sit here for 5 more minutes and you all will know everything about my life. Or you will vouch for that. But yeah, so I'm not a very private person. So I think the most important thing for me is just to own up to something. Like, I've made so many mistakes already, very, very publicly. Everyone has seen me say a lot of things and just...
Like, I remember when we were doing Coffee with Karan, the first thing you said was, I'm just like, nepotism.
I acknowledge it. I own up to it. Yeah. I'm not going to shy away from something. I'll be the first person to say that I'm privileged. So I think you just need to own up to it and you just need to stand by what you say and your decisions. And
but I have to say that I think it's an amazing thing that you've taken a stand on what you have. No, genuinely. You know, I think we take these issues very lightly. And for you, you could have been a young actress who didn't need to have an opinion. I think it's really remarkable that you chose to stand up against cyberbullying. I'm sure at some point there was a fear that it would backfire
and it has.
People,
it has.
Okay,
I feel
it
like
has.
After starting so positive, I've gotten so much more hate than I used to get before. But I feel like I'm just happy because I feel like somewhere out there I've at least stopped one person from saying something negative, and that's my mission accomplished, you know. And I feel like for me the whole point of this was just to speak about it, to, you know, create awareness and just take that first step, because I feel like no one was taking that step and I was like, why am I complaining that no one's taking that step? I should do something about it, right?
Absolutely.
And that's why I wanted to start the conversation mainly. Because
why don't you tell someone, tell us a little more about the initiative.
So it's a digital social responsibility and it's only on Instagram right now, but we basically have a handbook where they tell you how you can deal with certain situations, and we always have people that you can talk to, and we have numbers of hotlines, etc., where you can contact people. And it's just a safe, positive place where people can come and speak their mind and talk about their problems, and you'll get an answer back. So I think it's just a community of positive.
I mean, I have to say I learned a lot. Like, while I was researching for this talk, I had all the little cute And it never struck me earlier that we actually had a way to stop cyberbullying, right? And I mean, at some level, it's also criminal. So I think it's very important that we know what our rights are. And we also know that there's a community out there that's going to help us. And I think I think we have to give her a big round of applause for starting this. That's not big.
Raucous.
It's okay.
Okay.
We're going to throw the questions open to the audience. Is anyone, is there a mic going around?
Oh, hey.
Oh, I love her. Going, please. Let me warn you, no film questions, huh? Relevant questions.
Okay, so as I spoke to you, I do get a lot of questions. I'm not a professional, but I do tend to have like a lot of people. You know, there are cases where people get so bullied that they do have suicidal tendencies. And I'm associated with an organization called the Warren House Foundation. So I'm a part of their team. There will be listeners who speak to them. So I want to know that if somebody comes and approaches you, that, you know, they've been bullied so bad, that, you know, they're worried about themselves. What would you do, like, words of encouragement?
So I'm not a professional in this, as you said, even you aren't. So I don't know to what capacity I would be able to help them. But I think I'll definitely be a ear for them to listen, like, you know, shoulder for them to cry on, or a ear that, you know, I'll listen to their problems. Because I feel at that time, they don't want to listen to you. They just want to let whatever they have out, and they want to speak their mind. They just want to be heard at that point. And I feel like when they're talking out loud, they kind of make that decision, you know, in their head, and they probably not go with whatever step they were thinking of going. But I would probably try to get professional help, because I'm not a professional and I don't want to intervene in a step in that way. But I would definitely listen, and I wouldn't judge them for the decision that they're making. I would just listen, and hopefully that'll help.
Do you have like a team or something?
So, because it's not possible for me to physically be there and reply to everyone at all points of time, but there's someone 24/7 on the page ready to respond.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. So basically, I think it's more like you are the conduit to other people, right? And that's Anyone else have a question?
Yes.
If you have a loud voice, speak. Come and take my mic.
Hi. So I was scrolling down through your page on Instagram. I could actually connect to it. So I'm a singer, and I exclusively wrote a song for So Positive.
Really?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, can you sing it?
Can I play?
Sing it. Yes, please. You can sing it live.
They say you're too thin. They say you are black, you have an ugly skin. They make trolls on your face. They make comments on race. They make fake profiles and use your name. But I don't want you to care of the hate they always spread. And I just want you to say, with me, you'll always be so positive.
Nice. Can I give you a hug? That's so nice of you. Thank you so much. That's really sweet. That was very nice. How do I buy rights for this album? Okay. No, I want you to have like the
rights to it. Thank you. No, I will use you with it, like on the page somehow.
That's amazing. That, like, thank you.
Thank
anyone
you
else?
So much. Thank you.
Has anyone created a look since it's Fashion Week?
It was so positive.
She has a cute tee. Any other questions?
Oh, why do you think positivity comes into the fashion industry?
Well, I think the fashion industry actually is a very positive industry. I mean, of course, we have had our negative, not impact, but things have been said in a negative way. But I think it's actually the most inclusive industry. I feel everybody feels loved, creativity flows. And I think now more than ever, we are in such a strong space of feeling oneness, you know, and I think it's all about inclusivity. And I think we've always spread the message of diversity, always. I mean, Vicky's here with us, he's the star of that. And I think it's a good place to be. Would you guys agree?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Yeah. And also, when you look at design, like fashion design, it's so diverse that there's something for everyone.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
I mean, look at us, all of us here. We're all so differently dressed, but we're all so happy, yeah. Right? Spreading positivity, warriors.
Yes.
Anyone else?
Any songs, any dances?
Nobody has a question? It's very rare that you get her. Yeah, come.
Hi, Rebecca. What was that final moment, like that moment where, you know, you must have been feeling certain way, thinking about certain things, but what was that final moment where you thought, I should do something about it? And you thought of stuff?
So I remember when this college admission thing happened, when people said that I lied about it, I remember it was 2 days after Student of the Year had released, and I was the happiest person in the world because my film had just come out and I was getting so much love and I was feeling so grateful and blessed. And then 2 days later, this fiasco happened and I was like, why is this happening now? Like, you know, why is it happening to me? You know, like, I didn't know who these people were. I was like, why are they targeting me? What have I done to them? I actually reflected and went back to school. Did I ever say anything to anyone? And I couldn't think of anything. And That was the time when I remember I had a shoot the next day and I was like, cancel it, and I don't want to go, and I'm so upset and all that stuff. And then I just cried and cried and cried, and I was really upset. And then I let it all out, and then I spoke to my mom, and she was like, you know, but you're not the only person this is happening to. This is happening to so many people out there in the world, and you should do something about it. You have the platform to do something about it. You're an actor. People are going to listen to you. If you have a voice, use it well. And I think that's the time I decided that I wanted to do something about it. Yeah. Thank you.
How are we on time? Nobody's telling
me. We're okay on time. Talk forever, like, Anaya. Talk a lot.
Guys.
Yeah.
Ask us some more questions, otherwise we're going to have personal conversations.
Okay.
I'm sure they
want to
hear that.
You're both fabulous.
Thank you.
I'm a big believer in deleting negative comments, and you were saying I love that you don't really engage if people are super negative. But where I work, they don't believe in, they leave the comments like on the paper magazine post. But I just feel like it's best to kind of squash out that negativity. And someone can come and say, why did you put that person on the cover? Or why did you, and I'm happy to engage, but if they come in a very hateful, negative way. So what do you guys think about like deleting comments?
So I have to admit, I delete negative comments when I feel they're hurting the person that I've written about. If they say my work is shit, I delete. I'm like, yeah, okay, it's your opinion, buddy. And I feel like if I delete it, they'll think I'm so vain that I couldn't bear for someone to say something bad about my work, right?
Yeah.
But I feel very sensitive to the people I work with, because as you know, and the people you work with become an extension of your family, of your life. And I don't like anyone saying anything like this. So just like you, you know, I delete something that's mean or hurtful about someone. But having said that, you know, we keep saying it's free speech, so I'm always torn between the two. Like, should I just leave it? I don't know.
I leave it for sure, because I think if I delete one negative comment, 10 others will pop up, and I can't physically go and stop people from speaking. And I feel like just giving love back, you know, sometimes I'll reply to a hate comment with a heart. Yeah. And they're shocked. They're like, you know, so I think, I don't think it's pop. But I genuinely believe whatever floats your boat. If it makes you happy to delete the comment, please do that. And that's what So Positive says. It gives you ways and what all you can do, different ways. And it's your decision, whatever makes you happy. Honestly, whatever makes you happy. I personally don't think it's possible to delete all the comments.
But you also have 1,000 more comments than us.
Yeah.
no, I don't know. No, no, no. But I genuinely, like, maybe I would at one point be deleting comments. If it's too, like, if it's about my family, I get very upset. If I read something about my dad or my younger sister, I get very upset. And when it's about me, I don't care. Yeah.
Any other questions?
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Yeah, so body imaging is one of the major issues. So I wanted to know what are your views on body imaging issues.
Listen, I've been made fun of my entire life for being too thin. And people used to call me toothpick in school and used to make fun of the, like, I was so insecure about, because we used to wear skirts to school, like the way that my skirt was, if it was too long then my legs would look really, really thin, and if it was too short, obviously we weren't allowed to wear short skirts to school. So I've tried everything to try. I would wear track pants. We had a sports uniform, so instead of wearing the skirt, I would always wear the track pants because I was so insecure of how thin I was. And I think after coming into the industry, moreover, because there's so many more people who see me, I get such negative reviews about my body. Like, they say I'm like a patient who's run away from the hospital. I look like I have some disease. I'm constantly getting stuff. And then once I put on like 2 kgs and they were like, "Arey, ab moti ho gayi hai." So I was like, whatever I do, they're not going to be happy. So as long as I'm happy with my body, I'm eating healthy, I'm working out, whatever makes me happy. So it takes time to come to terms with it. But I think once you start accepting yourself the way that you are, what anyone says does not matter. Just love yourself. You're the one living in that body for the rest of your life. So as long as you're healthy, that's all that matters. Yeah. No matter how you look.
I have to add to that. You know, very often people ask me in interviews, so, you know, what are your fashion tips for this shape and this size? And I'm like, it doesn't change. It's about how you feel. Like, if you want to wear a tight dress, whatever size you are, it's about how you feel and how it makes you feel. So that's the important thing. So if you just love yourself for how you are and you feel good, right, mentally and physically, you're a winner.
The only shape that matters is the heart.
Mine's huge. I just did a cardiogram. It's huge.
Really?
Yeah. Anyway, time for 2 more questions. Anyone? Yes. Wait.
Right. What's my favorite fashion?
I'm flying all the way from Delhi.
Hi girls.
Hi.
Amazing. Very
Thank
beautiful.
You.
Very bright. What is your, this is not with reference to your conversation,
okay,
but just in fashion, since we are fashion week, what is your favorite fashion SKU? Like, is it a denim? Is it a blouse? Is it a t-shirt? Bathing suit? What is it? Sorry.
My slogan tees, actually. I'm always on slogan tees. I always have something funny written. I think everyone knows how silly my captions are on Instagram anyway. So I think the t-shirt version of my captions. And I think a nice pair of jeans. And the most comfortable in shorts or jeans. But I think, yeah, I'm just, I give comfort a lot of importance. Yeah.
No, absolutely. I mean, just earlier I was telling someone, I said, you know, whatever I'm wearing, I need to feel comfortable.
Because it shows if you're not. It really shows.
Absolutely. Everyone thinks, oh, you work at Vogue, you must dress up every day. Ask these Vogue ladies. We dress so badly to work. It's all about comfort. It's like jeans. For me, it's a ganji or a shirt. Look at them, they're all wearing the same.
Lululemon.
Yeah.
No Lululemon.
Sketchers.
I can't name brands, but anything goes. It's only about how it feels on my body.
Yeah.
Not what the label says.
And I mean, comfort can be different for anyone. Someone can be comfortable in a bodycon dress, but that's your level of comfort. So honestly, whatever flies with you is what's good.
And also, I think fashion has to be used as a mood enhancer, right? It's all about, I feel like on some days you wake up and you want to just be comfortable. And some days, however hard you try, only the blacks in your cupboard will like attract you. It's almost like an inner voice. And I mean, maybe I'm a bit of a victim for emotional dressing. But I feel that happens to me. Don't you feel it?
Always. Yeah. Like today I was feeling these jeans, the color, pink eyes, blue eyeliner. So yeah. How I feel.
And then she felt like, I don't want to wear my heels anymore. And she knocked them off.
No, right? I'm getting a cramp.
Oh dear. Okay. These chairs. Sorry, sponsor of the chairs. They're very
love these chairs.
Okay. One last question. They've kept me on my toes. It's like a leg workout. One last question. Anyone? Yes, sir.
Hi, Ninya.
Hi.
You are really very cute.
Hi,
thank you. Anaya's even cuter.
The light also. When you're being positive, say hello to both of us. That's
sorry.
Really nice.
So my question is that you have been working with many of the celebrities, right?
Yeah.
So what was your favorite movies part, like the scene which you are not going to forget?
Oh, that's a nice question. I'll just answer it. I think my favorite character will always be Shreya from Student of the Year, because it was my first one. And my most memorable scene was the scene in the film where my dad slaps me, because I don't have that sort of relationship with my father. So it was very hard for me to be in a position like that. And I really feel like I had to completely detach from myself to feel that emotion. And yeah, that was a really hard scene to do as well. And I really loved and valued my father even more after that. So
what
I think,
is there not to love about
him? I mean, yeah, my father's amazing. But he's the most positive person in the world, actually. I think I've got all that love and positivity and kindness from him. And all that laughter. Like, he's always joking and he's always laughing.
He's the warmest person.
Yeah, can I just tell you that I've met your father on a couple of occasions. He doesn't know who I am. Most people here don't know who I am.
We know who you are. Yeah.
Whenever we enter, we got into a lift and like, you hold that and it's a please and it's a thank you.
Yeah,
so, you know, guys, that's pretty much what we should take away from this. Let's try and say good afternoon, good evening to everyone.
Yes.
Smile, please, thank you. You know, that's. Let's start here.
Yes.
What do you guys say? At Fashion Week, Nikita, can we make sure that we put this up? And we get everyone to wish each other, greet each other every morning, every afternoon, every evening.
Yes,
is that
done. I love
that.
And
look into each other's eyes.
Yeah. All right.
Yes, that's a good note to end it on.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you so much. For